So today we're going to be making this easy yet delicious egg fried rice. It's just yummilicious.
And welcome back to Akshata's Recipes. Thank you so much for stopping by. Well, in today's video, I'm going to be showing you a very simple egg fried rice, which is so delicious. And it is one of those very quick recipes which you make on a nice high flame and it gets ready just like this. And it is made with very few ingredients, stuff that we always have in our kitchen or our pantry. It's, you know, when you're really craving for something quick and you're hungry and you don't want to put a lot of effort into making some elaborate meal, you just want to toss stuff together and make this amazing fried rice. This is the recipe that you need to do. I need to try. So I hope you like today's recipe, and if you do, then don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to hit the red subscribe button, become a part of Akshata's Recipes family. And once you have subscribed, don't forget to click the bell. That way, whenever I put up a new video, you can be the first one to know. So let's start. Now we're going to start by cooking the rice. We want to parboil the rice. So here I have about 1 cup of rice, which I've thoroughly washed and cooked till it is a little bit undone. And then we're just going to drain out all the excess water. And once we drain the water, we're just going to leave it for about 5 minutes till it all comes together. And then when you see the rice, it is nice and separated. It's not sticky. So it's just perfect for fried rice. Now let's take a look at all the other ingredients we need for this recipe. Here I have 2 eggs, which I have just beaten up. Then we're going to be using 1 medium-sized onion, which has to be chopped really fine. You can use the red onion or you can go with the spring onion too. Then this is a mixture of 2 light green chilies chopped very fine, 5 cloves of garlic and 1 inch of ginger. You got to chop everything really fine. This is about 1 teaspoon of black pepper powder. Then we have some salt to taste. Like many of you who have been watching me for some time know that I have now switched to Himalayan pink salt. And we're going to use 2 tablespoons of red chili sauce. To that I've added about 1/2 teaspoon of Szechuan chutney. Just give all of this a nice mix. You can cut down the quantity if you don't want it very spicy. Here is 2 tablespoons of soya sauce. And a little bit of chopped coriander. You can also go with some chopped spring onions. So let's start making this delicious, quick and easy dish. So here I've heated a pan on a medium to high flame and I'm adding about 1 tablespoon of regular cooking oil as well as 1 tablespoon of this sesame oil. Now this really adds an amazing flavor, but if you don't have it, just go with 2 tablespoons of regular cooking oil. And we want our pan to be nice and hot, because like you know, fried rice has to be really done on a little higher flame and everything has to be put in quick, fried well. So first we're going to add this chopped up ginger, garlic and chilies, and we're going to fry this really well on a medium to high flame, continuously stirring the ginger, garlic and the green chilies. And we're going to fry this till the garlic starts becoming a nice golden, almost a burnt color. This really adds an awesome flavor to the rice. Now we're going to add in our chopped onion. Like I said, I'm going with regular red onion. You can also use the spring onion and fry this really well too. Till the onion is also golden brown, go with a very medium to high flame, continuously keeping an eye on it and stirring it. Now I've already beaten the eggs in advance because we are going to add this and we are going to scramble it in the pan itself on a high flame till we get a scrambled egg. So with a fork, very gently, you can just mix everything together like this, and we have to fry this egg very well. So it has to get a little bit of a brownish tinge. So once you've scrambled it, then with your spatula, just fry it well. and then break it up into smaller pieces. And now we're just going to add this cooked rice. As you've seen, the method in which I've cooked the rice is not sticky. The grains are separating very easily. And this is really important when you're making fried rice. I will leave a link for my recipe on how I cook this rice, you know, step by step. You can check that link out. Here I've just shown it to you quite quickly. Otherwise, the video would become really very long. So I will leave a link below on how I cook my rice. I cook this rice even for my regular, you know, if I'm having rice and dal or whatever, because it is a much healthier way of eating rice. Now we're going to add the soya sauce. I'm going with a little more of the soya sauce because I want that lovely brown color. Now I'm adding some red chili sauce, which is a mixture of red chili sauce and Szechuan chutney. Now, I said you can cut this quantity of spiciness down or you can increase it. All depends upon how much spice you like in your fried rice. I really love it. Very, very spicy. So give all of this a nice, good mix on a very high flame and be very quick with it and mince up everything well, fry everything well. That's why your pan too has to be really nice and hot. Your oil has to be really nice and hot and you have to really mix everything very, very fast. Now, I've stuck to just, you know, keeping it simple with the egg. But if you like to make it even more fancy, you can add some fried sausages. You can go with some prawns. You can add whatever you like to this rice to make it even more delicious. Now, we're going to add the pepper powder. You can add as little or as much as you like. I like a lot of pepper powder and I'm adding some salt to taste. Now the soya sauce also has a little bit of salt content, so keep an eye for that. And it's always better to add a little less salt in the beginning, taste your food, and then you can always add more salt because you cannot eat very salty food. It's just not appetizing at all. So fry everything well. It's a fried rice, so you have to keep frying everything on a very high flame. And then we're just going to add this lovely chopped up coriander. Besides adding a color to the dish, it also adds a lovely flavor. You can also add spring onions, but just fry your spring onions a little bit before adding it. It gives a nice crunch. And friends, your egg fried rice is all ready to eat. You can see that it has this lovely dark color. I love the dark color in my egg fried rice. And the trick in eating this is you have to serve it really piping hot. So every time you know you plan to serve it, just give it a one big stir in a hot pan and serve it really hot. This is a dish in itself. You don't need to add any gravy or anything. It's really, really, you know, a very it's like comfort food when you're watching your favorite movie or you're reading your favorite book. This is my go-to, you know, meal. It's really, really delicious. So I hope you like today's quick, easy, delicious recipe. Let me know in the comments box below whether you like this recipe and when you tried it out, how did it turn out? If you like this video, then don't forget to give it a big like. I need those thumbs ups for my channel. For those of you who haven't subscribed yet, please click the red subscribe button. And once you have subscribed, click the bell. So every time I put up a new recipe, you'll be the first to know. And for all my lovely subscribers and viewers, I thank you from the bottom of my heart for stopping by my channel and watching my videos, giving me the thumbs ups, giving me your lovely supporting comments. Thank you so much, guys. Have a great day to all of you. And I will catch you in my next video. Take care. Have a great day. Bye.